Welcome to the very first episode of Dell CXO Digital Drive. I'm Ankit Vengurlekar, and on this show, with some of India's top CIOs, we are going to explore avenues and possibilities for a better tomorrow by understanding how digitalization is transforming workforce industries. Now, we're going to get an in-depth understanding of the healthcare sector today with my special guest, who I'm going to take on a nice drive. Let's go meet the CIO of Fortis Healthcare, Veneeth Purushotaman. As a transformational CIO, he has led one of the most ambitious digital transitions in the sector. Let's meet the man of the hour. Hello, Veneeth, how are you doing?
Very good, very good.
It's good to finally meet the man of the hour in person. I've heard so much about you.
Thank you so much.
Okay, and I'm waiting to get my mind blown with all the insights. But first up, let's turn this day around and let's go for a drive.
Let's go.
All right.
Look forward, thank you.
Welcome to Dell CXO Digital Drive.
Thank you.
Really excited to have you here with us on the drive. And there's going to be a lot of driving. I obviously have a lot of questions to know from you, and also a few maybe secrets about the healthcare industry.
but let's
start with the digital transformation. You know, the healthcare sector, just like so many other industries and sectors, there's a complete transformation that's happening because of digital technology, because of IT, because of virtualization, because of business intelligence, artificial intelligence, so many things happening. If you can help me get stock of where the healthcare sector stands as of today, and what are some of the challenges in adoption of IT and digital transformation?
It is true that just like every other sector, healthcare will also go through the digital transformation. The shift is not, again, a matter of choice. It's because the environment is demanding that.
Okay.
So that's very important. If you allow me a few seconds on this, is that healthcare, as I said, because of this huge transformation that it's going through, one of the biggest problem that healthcare providers like us are trying to now address is the whole discussion around trust, around the cost of healthcare, and I believe one of the only way that this can be addressed is by going this journey of digitization.
Because digital is equal to transparent.
Exactly. So transparency is what comes out. Like, transparency will build trust. So if it is, whether it is the clinicians that we have, in which hospital they are, what is the price at which I'm doing a particular procedure or a particular treatment, how do I go about it? Is everyone that we have, the doctors and the people that we have on board, are they qualified enough? Every information is out there, right? It's important that you make everything transparent for people to build trust. That's one aspect. The second aspect is how do you manage cost otherwise? The best way to manage cost is to optimize your processes.
Absolutely.
And if you have to optimize your processes and you have to tweak it well, you can't do it without automations,
right?
Without solutions, without putting technology behind it. And then let the care providers focus on the real care. The aspects of empathy, the aspects of taking care of the of somebody who has come to you for being treated, and not waste their time filling forms and signing 10 consent things. So consent forms and things like that. So I believe that's why the whole digitization piece for healthcare is imperative, and it's going to really change the whole landscape in the few years to come.
Absolutely. So with all this critical and sensitive information up on the cloud, data security is of paramount importance.
Yes.
How is that being approached, and what, if any, are the challenges when it comes to data security?
The data security when it comes to healthcare information is of paramount importance. Most of the providers have this data up in the cloud. Further to that, you put a lot of healthcare information is not kept, is kept in a public cloud, but within the geographical boundaries of the country.
Okay.
As per the rules. And you also put multiple level of firewalls and mechanisms so that it is not available without a two-factor or more authentications. The record is first accessible and accessible only by the patient themselves.
Right.
And by the provider with whom the person has given the consent.
Okay.
Because the consent is part of the process as we go. When you go into a hospital and go through any process, you actually sign a consent.
Correct.
That gives the provider, because without that he can't treat you.
So that
authorization is there.
Correct.
So without that, nobody has an access. So there is another aspect of the whole information security, and when it comes to which I keep talking about whenever I get an opportunity, it's not just about putting endpoint security, jamming up all the ports and gateways. It's a lot about awareness.
Correct.
Right. Even if you do all of that, it can still be one employee or one person within your organization who just does something without being aware of, who end up compromising a huge amount of data.
How does the role of the CIO absorb and reflect these changes? How have you seen the role of a CIO at Fortis evolve?
The role of the CIO has evolved over a period, a lot depends on the CIO himself. It's the CIO himself who has to change it, because it is not anybody else waiting to come and change the role of a CIO.
Right.
So you have to do it yourself, and that comes from how well you work with the business, how closely you work with the business, and how good a business leader you are than just a technology leader.
Mm-hmm.
So it's important that the CIO role is about working with the business, closely working with the business, and giving them the solutions that they need. Technology is not just an enabler anymore. Technology is there to create the differentiator. It's you're working with the business more and creating a differentiation.
Absolutely.
And creating that edge for the business to perform well, to make more revenues, more top line, more bottom line, and so on. So that's where the shift happened, the role. And then, like I mentioned earlier in the discussion, that the digitization journey is not just a CIO prerogative. It's not just a CIO responsibility.
Each and every.
All of this, each of the things that we're doing, because what we're doing is we're changing the complete way of working for an organization. It just cannot happen by a technology guy running it. It's not no more a technology discussion. It's much beyond. So transforming the way we work in the office, we talk to people, we connect with people, everything is changing. So the role has to change. The role has changed and has done well.
What do you think of taking a chota sa coffee break?
Sure, it'll be wonderful, great.
And you know, for Fortis, you are a multi-city operation, massive employee base. How has the workplace transformation happened?
So we actually recently decided to invest in the workplace by Facebook.
Oh, really?
Exactly. So that is one of those solutions that we have now gone live with. The reason why we thought of doing that was, when you talk about any intra-company communication,
right?
There was always a gap that we're not able to reach the last man standing.
Okay.
Right. We were neither able to reach them or reach them in a finite time. It's important that you're able to connect. And in today's times, it's not just about connect, it's about engaging, right? It's about the two-way conversation that is important.
But this is so remarkable. As the CIO, and as from my conversation with you, I've figured out how much you love technology and reading about it, all aspects of it. You constantly have to be on your toes about these new developments, have the appetite to sample these, and have the gumption to go ahead with a bold new change, which sometimes you are a pioneer in your industry or your sector.
Yeah.
Does that really excite you when you, like, is that something that you really look forward to first thing in the morning every day?
It does excite you. So it excites you to give, like I said, I continue to say, it excites you to give solutions and solutions to people in the business, which let them do their work better. So if you, and in this case,
save life.
I'm just saying, workplace is just one of those things.
Right, of course.
There are several other solutions that we're working on with the business, where we're trying to build solutions which move a lot of their process back onto the technology, onto
fantastic. Let's talk a little bit about the future, Veneeth, because the future is everybody's favorite muse. By 2020, what are some of the big changes or developments you envision happening in the healthcare sector and at Fortis Healthcare?
I can again speak about healthcare and in general about also about also and also about Fortis because as we speak, like I said, I don't have a crystal ball which I can gaze, but specifically with whatever knowledge I have about healthcare and the way we are as of now, I believe healthcare and healthcare providers and hospitals would be a place where people go by 2020 only for chronic illness.
Oh.
And people will stay away from going to the hospital for most of the other things.
Okay.
And why am I saying that? Because as you said earlier, with the Amazons and the Googles of the world coming into the space, it will go very much like many other industries have gone, whether it is retail or telecom, where most of the information is right there in their palm, on their mobile phones, and they could do a great deal of that sitting at home.
Do you think wearables and IoT, Internet of
Definitely.
Things, is going to be a major reason for disruption of the way business is done today?
Yeah, so it is all part of this. It will be all part of this whole part of the game in a way, because each of them will have a role to play. So
transactions could become cashless as well.
Transactions are already cashless
right.
to a great extent. Yes, the insurance will definitely become a larger component, because most of the people would move on to insurance-based healthcare treatments. Even now we have a lot of cash. That will also happen.
Right.
So by 2020 we should have a much mature healthcare environment and ecosystem, as I say, wherein it will be there could be the patient data could be sitting in one single place. Where people don't have to carry files.
We've had a long, in-depth chat, and I think we're going to wrap up this edition of the CXO Drive with a fun rapid fire.
Okay.
All right, and here goes the rapid fire. क्या आप तैयार हैं खेलने के लिए विनीत? Tea or coffee?
Coffee.
Morning or night?
Morning.
Last book you read?
Pride and Joy by Alex Knight. It's a book on theory of constraints in healthcare. Very interesting book.
Whoa. आप ऑफ टाइम में भी हेल्थ केयर के बारे में पढ़ते हैं क्या?
लव इट.
ओके. सिनेमा और थिएटर?
थिएटर.
ओके. वीकेंड और वीकडेज?
वीकेंड.
कार्डियो और जॉगिंग?
कार्डियो.
टैबलेट और लैपटॉप?
Laptop, but so this, look at this, these kind of devices are still amazing. This is the crossover or the hybrid form where it's a laptop as well as the tablet.
Oh my God, best so got, of both the worlds.
Yeah, so stuff, this is... This
tablet
is
what, when you want it, I laptop think, when you want it.
Exactly.
Wow. Veneeth Purushotaman, thank you so much for this lovely
pleasure.
Chat.
It was a pleasure meeting
you. I couldn't have had a better first episode on this amazing CXO Digital Drive. And
pleasure.
I am going away supremely enriched with all the information that you've spoken about and extremely optimistic about the future of healthcare thanks to the disruption of technology.
Yep.
And thanks so much.
Thank
for
you so
all
much. Pleasure, privilege, and thank you so much for having me on the show.
Pleasure's been all mine, Veneeth.
Thank you so much.